Hello, everybody. Very happy to meet again with you, even if virtually this year due to the coronavirus restrictions. So let's start from where we stopped ourselves last year. And allow me, please, to share with you what really great you did last year. So take a look at this. Wonderful last year, and even better this. So let's start all together, and let's focus on something that you know very well and you are able to value very well. International sales. Nothing to say because you are a really seasoned executive, but something to share regarding the main focal point. So our focal point this year is cross-cultural communication. So we have expected to jump altogether within a movie. The first movie is Red Corner, with Richard Gere trying to sell TV content to the Siamese Central Censorship Committee. And we have expected to figure out a couple of indicators in order to have a deeper understanding and to be able to better manage similar situations, similar challenges that you are expected to face very quickly in a couple of weeks during our on-the-job module and then again during your daily working life. So let's jump all together within the movie. It's the very beginning. We are expected to be part of the scene as observers.
With his cigarettes, the man. Lou is his name. He decides what to buy.
So how are we doing?
They got problems with the TV package. That's why we flew you in on such short notice.
They seem to be enjoying themselves. So who's the competition? Germans already been here?
Hoffman came in yesterday.
Ah, right in time. Showtime.
The director has real concerns about your programming package. He says your programs are pornographic, violent, and superstitious.
As of course they are.
You lost your mind?
Okay, we've made a recommendation and would like you to comment.
Your great chairman Mao once said, you'll have to excuse this pronunciation, I'm sorry. Yang Wei Zhong Yong.
Yang Wei Zhong Yong.
Use the West for Chinese purposes. Now, is that true or am I mistaken? If our programming teaches your people that America is imperfect, often violent and prurient, wouldn't that tend to discourage the pursuit of Western values?
摩尔先生说的有道理啊，我看我们回去再研究研究吧。
With some deletions, perhaps we can come to an understanding. Let us talk among ourselves.
谢谢.
So this year is the time for international sales. And our focus is cross-cultural communication within international sales negotiation processes. So a lot of contextual intelligence, a lot of diversity management. in a highly realistic environment, from famous movies. Being all together, jumping all together within a movie is really an effective way to start analyzing, understanding, chatting, talking, exchanging opinions about what great international negotiations are able to do and to reach. Agree or not? What do you think? So please start using the chat. So what's happened? What do you think is really worthy in order to start analyzing what's happened there? Okay. I'm reading a lot of very interesting observations, insights, some evaluations. And right now we have, in my opinion, in between don't reject the battery frame and search for mutual gains, and that we are in the same page, because all the comments you are providing and exchanging over our chat are going toward the same direction. So please go deeper and provide your first insights about the reframing approach that Richard Gere performed, as well as the way he was trying to find mutual gains in between the A-Team and the Chinese Censorship Committee. Wonderful. Lot of observations, very interesting. Fully agree with all what I'm reading from your side. Allow me to say something more about don't reject the battery frame. Allow me to do so by my avatar.
Don't reject, reframe. What do you think about such a motto? The art of reframing is to maintain the conflict in all its richness, but to help people look at it in a more open-minded and hopeful way. Reframing is the process of changing the way a thought is presented, so that it maintains its fundamental meaning, but is more likely to support resolution efforts. Let me say that reframing is a major technique to develop a win-win negotiation and to go beyond a merely adversarial thinking that generates vicious spirals more than concrete results for all the involved negotiators. So, better reframing than rejecting. And what about his communication strategy? Please let me know if you agree or not with the following statements.
Let's answer our questions, taking a look for the second time at the same cut. So, second time we are looking at the same very important scene. What we can say about the counterparts? They were all and only physically attending the scene, or in your opinion, there are hidden counterparts or virtual counterparts or counterparts that are effectively real counterparts but not attending this meeting? Yeah, you're right. The Germans have maybe the main and from Richard Gere perspective, most dangerous counterparts, not physically attending the meeting, but well established, because their presence is really well established. The rapport they have with the Chinese censorship committee is strong enough to be really a dangerous counterpart. Oh, what about the context of the negotiation? Do you have any observation, suggestion about this? You recall from last year, roles and goals, negotiation styles, verbal, not verbal communication, win-win strategies and tactics, management of emotions within the teams that are facing challenging negotiation scenarios. The BATNA, the best alternative to a negotiated agreement, is a key concept, as well as trying to figure out the level of the involved authorities, because a lot of what we are saying is about authority, is about what is really important. Who are the key people better? Let's say, who are the key people here? As well as values and regulations, the rules also, the ethical, the juridical, the legal, let's say, environment where people are performing what they have doing there. So, a lot of elements, a lot of different areas that we have to focus on. So we performed a nice first journey inside a very interesting movie. And we are figuring out a lot of tactics and strategies that could be very useful. Let me share something from my screen. Can you see? Yeah, this is a checklist. It's a three-page checklist. We are at the very beginning of the checklist. And thanks to tools like this, we can try to penetrate a little bit the mindset of our counterpart. In this case, we are trying to figure out what the Chinese censorship committee is expecting from us. Are you okay? What do you think about those type of situations? Do you need to be provided by me with more examples, or for the moment is good enough and we can go further? Okay. So let's go for them, and let's say this. Life is really all about how we see things. By the way, how many people or from how many perspective are you able to look at the people or at the person from our image? Yeah? At least two, okay. At least same person, two different perspectives. It's all about how we see things. Negotiation is a socially constructed process. It's a process where the glasses we are wearing and we are looking through, the windows we are looking through, are making the reality. We are co-building with the counterparts, as well as with our colleagues from the same team. So it's really a co-building process that we have expected to face. Sounds strange? Sounds understandable? Do you agree? Do you disagree? So let's close for today. What's the question? I'm still in your mind. Are there any questions? I'm here now, or I'm available during office hours from tomorrow, as well as by email or by Slack. So please feel free to reach me your preferred way. Thank you guys for attending. Wonderful, as usual. Bye-bye. See you soon.